Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to another Aqua's Adventure. Today, like always, we're on my single-player world and we're gonna have lots of fun. I've done a lot of things off-camera, so we'll get to those. And yeah, guys, let's get started. Alright, guys, so let's start with these signs over here, and we're just gonna go one by one, but we're gonna start here. I lit everything up. So guys, I don't think it's a secret that you guys do know that I play in peaceful mode. Partly because it's easier, I don't have to eat, I don't have to worry about creepers blowing up everything. But one day, I'm going to have to go into easy or normal or hard, and I will have to face mobs. And if that does happen, my place is kind of in danger. So what I had and went and done is torched up everything. So my base as a whole looks uglier now because there's torches running everywhere. But the thing is, I have to play smart. If I ever need to go like creeper hunting or something, and I go on easy and not everything's lit up, I'm gonna have tons of creepers spawn everywhere, and things are gonna blow up, and things are just gonna go bad. So, just to update, I did kind of light up my world a bit, made it more kind of normal Minecraft friendly when you're not in peaceful. It's one of the things, just maybe preparing myself for going to those types of modes. Let's go to this one next. Well, actually, no, let's go to this one, because this has to do with this one. I updated the fishing farm since last episode, and I've done over 24 hours of farming. And updated gear goes with it. So we can go over there, and we can talk about a few things. Also, there's something really sad that's going to happen to fishing farms, or at least the design that I built. But real quick, let's go over here. I'm pretty sure last episode we built just a building, but since last episode I actually added a storage system, so... Yeah, when I farm, I do over like 12 hours of farming, so I do need a good storage system. Every time I farmed, it got all the way up into these chests about, so it was good that I built more. Now, here is the loot. Now, you guys remember, this is over 24 hours of farming, and you might say that's a lot. It's really not. It's maybe two nights, and look at all the stuff we've gotten. I'll just go through all of these, and you might say, oh, well, something, something, something. This is where it surprised me. Look at all these saddles and these name tags. So yeah, I've gotten a bunch of stuff, and this is only maybe 24 hours. And you also got to think of this. A lot of this stuff I've actually used, these books and these bows, went into the updated gear. So that was another one of the signs. If you guys look at my gear, because of this fishing farm, literally the one right in front of us, I have the best gear in the game. So... I know I spruced up my armor a bit, so I got protection. Protection isn't too high, but the feather falling high and the unbreaking. Protection, unbreaking, protection, unbreaking. So everything's got at least protection and unbreaking, and this has feather falling. But the cool part comes with my gear. So I'll go one by one. Efficiency 4, unbreaking 3, shovel. Now see, this actually is efficiency 5. Okay, well here, let me say this again. I have an efficiency 5 unbreaking 3 that I got from this, but it's in my chest because it's broken. So I'm picking this up as temporary, but I do have an efficiency 5 unbreaking 3 one now. This pick has efficiency 5 unbreaking 3 mending and knockback apparently, but guys, efficiency 5 and mending. This is an unbreakable pick. My bow, mending, power 4, punch 2, flame, and infinity, so it's a god bow. This fishing rod never breaks, and I'll explain that in a second. We got my sword, unbreaking 3, sharpness 5, mending, efficiency 4, knockback, and infinity. And we got my efficiency 5, unbreaking 3. So guys, oh, and not to mention my silk touch, efficiency 4, unbreaking 3. Guys, we have this is the best gear in the game, really. It just really is. By the way, this, if you guys don't know, in the latest update, I think it was 1.8 or 1.9, they added a mending enchantment. What mending does is, if you have a weapon in your hand that's broken, if you collect XP, it actually heals or repairs your weapon. So, guys, when you fish, whatever you catch, you get XP from. And this fishing rod is mending on it. So, guys, what that does is every time I fish, I get XP. And I've farmed over, like I said, 24 hours with this. It hasn't broken because it's literally an infinite rod. It will never break. My pick, I have used this one to break, I think, thousands of blocks at this point. It's never going to break. All I have to do is go, like, herd or breed animals or find coal or something, and it just repairs itself. Same with the bow. Every time I kill a mob, it'll just repair itself. Same with the sword. So guys, the only thing I don't have mending is really my shovel and my axe, and I could put mending on those, but let's look at a few things. So this is just kind of bad enchantments right here. This is a good enchantment. So everything in here has some quality. So it's either like power 4, efficiency 4, protection 4, infinity, silk touch. This one's mending. So, and you got to remember, this chest is actually filled up until about here. The thing is, I used a lot of it to get mending on like all of these four. So it's pretty cool. Here's a bunch of bows that we got. Some of them have like infinity. But guys, I'm just telling you now. These bows, like infinity bows, might be very rare to you. They're honestly not for me. I can, you know what, watch this. See, this, guys, do you see this infinity bow? It's, wow, a very good infinity. Yeah, I don't really need it. Because, literally, this farm is insane. And now, if we go up here to the good ones, every single one of these bows is mending on it. I have over, like, how many is this? Like, 10 mending bows. They'll never break. I don't even need any more bows in my life. These are just fishing rods. These are the kind of the crappy ones. We've got some good ones here. Every single one of these fishing rods is mending on it. So I've got unlimited fishing rods. I've got fish for my life. Salmon for my life. I got enough pufferfish for thousands of potions. I got enough clownfish to probably make a showroom. Saddles. I don't even need to look for saddles in my life. Name tags. I probably need more name tags, but it's just cool having this many. And there's just a bunch of junk here. But guys, I just want to show you, this farm is insane. So yeah, those are kind of the things. I have one more big thing. You might have just saw it in the corner there. But yeah, really, I just lit up the place. I used the fishing farm to get a bunch of stuff. Updated my gear. And also, it's just a little side thing. I was running low, pretty low on animals, so I bred some more. We finally have some sheep and some cows up in here. Now, guys, here is where the big surprise is going to come in. Because this is what I've been working on quite a little bit. And you guys have already seen it. I'm going to take this one down, take that one, take that one, and take that one. So, I don't know if you just read that, but you guys heard it right. Today, we are starting a castle. But we're not really starting today. We're going to finish the wall of the castle today. And you guys will see it in a second, but before we do go out there and see the castle itself, I just want to show you guys this wall. So guys, I spent a good 2 to 3 hours literally running in circles around the world, thinking of ideas. Actually, like, I won't say original because other people do this, obviously, but fun ideas that we could actually do and have some fun with, kind of like building a castle. So if you guys want to read all these are the ideas I've come up with so far. And this is going to last us. A lot of people say, how can you come up with so many episodes? Don't you get bored of Minecraft? No, I don't get bored of Minecraft because, I mean, I don't want to insult people here, but if you're creative enough, you can think of something. Just in a couple hours, I've thought of this stuff. We still haven't made the longest fall possible. Go from the top of the world all the way to the bottom. We've had from the top to, like, the middle. We've never gone to the bottom. We haven't built a chess arena. We haven't built a pyramid. We haven't made a giant glass potion with water in it or something. We haven't built a mini aquarium. We haven't built a bonfire grill area, a tent area. We haven't built a car. We haven't built a music disc farm yet. We haven't built, this is kind of weird. It's like stands with like slime blocks or rest. So we haven't done that. We haven't had anything with note block fun. We haven't gotten to get more Elytra. We haven't built an ice rink, stadium, enderpearl games, pixel arts, TNT cannons. We can build a Pokemon arena. We haven't gotten creeper heads. We haven't built dinosaur skeletons. We haven't built my house in real life. An underwater mini hub. We haven't built a lighthouse. Just so many things. If you're creative enough, you can think of them. And we're going to do all these in the next coming episodes. And this is just the beginning of the list. If I think of any more, I'm going to put these up here. But for now, what we're going to focus on the start of the castle. Now, I'm going to take this down. And really, it's not the start of the castle. It's almost the end of the wall. But here, I'm going to stop rambling. You guys want to see the castle. Let's go see the castle. And this is the front. You guys might say, well, wait, the castle's already done. You built the entire wall. You didn't get any of this on camera. Yeah, but you guys will see the other sides of it. But guys, yeah, off camera, I started building a castle. So this is like the front of the castle. Oh, okay. Well, that's why I added gates here. And I have like all my materials here that I need to build with. So this is the front of the castle. Now, I didn't want to have this entire thing. These are like chain. But we can kind of walk in through here. Now, you guys might... This is where I really got bored one day and I wanted to build so bad. So I built a ton, but I had to force myself to stop building. So I have something to record today. So today we're going to finish off that wall. And we do need to add some water. But yeah, guys, this is kind of the gate. And then I made a certain pattern all around the wall. You guys can see this pattern. And we built a moat here. I do want to have like a kind of a medieval castle. So we built a moat all around. Now, here's the thing. I only did the moat on this side over here. On the back here, I actually did build the wall. Completely built the wall. But I did not put the moat under here. So you guys can see over here. So yeah, there's no moat. But I did build the wall all the way around. And guys, yeah, one day, if you guys want to know how it kind of happened, one of these days, I just got really bored and I wanted to build something. Kind of what happened with those houses over there and the igloo, I just kind of felt like building. So I started building a castle. And it just kind of went from there. I just started building and building and building. And this is a broken block right here. That was probably a glitch. And yeah. We still need to put the water in. We do need to finish that wall, which that's what we're going to do today. Today, our goal is put the water in and finish that last wall. Now, real quickly, I do want to show you guys what it looks like from above. So we're going to do two things. We're going to look at the map in our little like living room area or whatever it's called, and then we'll go up super high and take a look at it from there. But yeah, if we go over here to our map, on the map, this is kind of what it looks like. Obviously, there's nothing here right now, but once we get this, we'll have a moat all the way around, and it's gonna be really cool. The actual size of the castle itself is practically the size of, it's a little bit even bigger than my house. It's bigger than the maze, so it's fairly big. I actually wanted it bigger, but the thing is, I had to kind of stop myself at some point, because if I want to get it bigger, it's gonna grow infinitely bigger, and honestly, I'm kind of scared of it growing way too big, and then I don't know how to fill it, because guys, you gotta remember, this is just a wall. We have to fill the wall at some point. So, yeah, what we're going to do, we're going to go up high. Okay, guys, so from a high point of view, and this is what it looks like. Okay, let's put the elytra wings on just in case if we fall off, we'll be able to fly. So, yeah, this is kind of what it looks like from here. Now, I know the clouds are blocking it, so we'll walk a little bit over here. But yeah, we'll even fly down, but this is kind of what it looks like from down here. I think it's going to look epic once we actually fill it in. I'm planning to build like a giant temple in here. It's going to be sick. So, yeah, I guess we got nothing to do but jump down a bit. Yep, I was going to say, hopefully we're flying. Oh, we're going to hit that. Oh, I forgot to mention this in the signs. It's actually perfect. I went to the village area, and I actually fenced it off and lit it up. So in case, like I said, if we go into an easy or normal mode, and those zombies will get in there, and they won't all die, obviously. Even lit up Steve, I lit up everything. So guys, real quickly, what we gotta do, though, is we did ride the roller coaster to get up there, and of course, every time you ride that, you do have to pay diamonds. And I'm a man of my word, so yeah, let's take, I don't know how much it was, I think it was 5 diamonds. We're gonna put those diamonds up there, and I'll meet you guys back at the castle, and we'll start working on the last wall. Okay, so let's grab some material. So I know we need a lot of stone. Let's grab a bunch of stone. We need some torches. We need some slabs. We need some brick. And I think that's pretty much it just for the initial build. Oh, forgot one thing. We do need some stairs. So we'll grab some of those. And yeah, I think we'll need much, much more. But I did smelt a bunch. How much more do you have? Okay, let's just fill up our inventory. Let's head over there. And yeah, we'll build this last wall. I might put it into a time lapse, because it's still a pretty big wall. I still have to build it. I built like the little edges of it. But yeah, guys, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna just start building. Alright guys, so yeah, the wall is actually done. You guys saw me build it. Am I missing anything? Actually, I am missing something. Okay, guys, now the wall is done after I put in those small slabs. But yeah, the entire wall is completely done all the way around. But actually, I just thought of one more thing that we still haven't done. Okay, one more second. Alright, guys, for the final time, and now the wall is done. I forgot to add those little slabs up there. Now, all we have left on the actual wall part, the outside part, is to add the water. I even put, like, the stone brick over here, so we're all good with that. Literally just the water, and then the outside and the wall is really done. So, guys, the water is gonna probably be super, super hard. Guys, just imagine how many water buckets this is gonna take. This is gonna take a very long time. So, what I'm gonna do is do that completely off camera. I'll be right back once it's done. Alright, everybody, the moat, I think it's a moat, is completely done. I've gone all the way around with practically what it felt like millions and millions of buckets, and the entire thing is done all the way around. I'm not going to walk around because it's going to take forever, but guys, yeah, the outside of the wall is kind of done. And now we're only about 15 minutes into the video, so we are going to do something else. I'm going to go to the wall, I'm going to see what we can do, and we'll pick one from there. But real quickly, I do want to show you guys the view from the wall, because I built the wall where you can go on top of it on a reason, because I want it to be kind of like medieval. I completely forgot, we can actually press those buttons. But let's go on top of here. And yeah, this is like kind of like a watchtower. You can actually watch from here. So I did think of making it higher. The thing is, I don't want to go super high, because then you won't even be able to see the, like, the castle temple thingy. But yeah, I made it where you could walk up here, kind of have a little bit of fun. And there's obviously only one entrance, which is that. So we can't get on from any other entrance, just like kind of a real castle. And then here, guys, right now, just imagine a giant temple slash castle. So we're going to have it here, and then we're probably going to have, like, little villages on the side. We might have, like, a little river running through. We might have some farms in here. It's going to be a lot of fun. But real quickly, I'm not going to even cut because I don't think it's going to take that long. Let's go to the list, and let's pick something. At this point, I'd ask you what you guys want to do, but you're not here, sadly. So, you know what? I think we're going to do, we're going to build a Pokemon arena with iron golems and name tags. This is going to be our mission for right now. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to get some materials together and then we'll start building. But I do want to get materials first. Pick the position out where we're going to build this. And I'm completely freehanding this. We're going to build a little Pokemon arena right here. And I'm just going to kind of not tell you guys like all the details, but I'm just gonna tell you this. I've built this in another world and I really liked it. This is just kind of like a super, super small fun little project. But yeah, guys, I don't know what parts I'm gonna time lapse or what parts I'm gonna show, but what we're gonna do is we're gonna build like a little Pokeball in here. Then we're gonna fill it with two iron golems. We're gonna name one Ash Ketchum and the other one Gary Oak, obviously from Pokemon. So yeah, I remember building this in, I think, my second survival world ever. It wasn't on YouTube or anything, it was just by myself. I built this, and I thought it looked really cool. Every time I stepped outside, I was kind of just, like, looked at it. Always kind of really liked it. So, yeah, what we're going to do is we're going to have to start with the Pokeball. Now, I don't know where the middle is. I'm just going to guess probably this is the middle. So, I don't know exactly what Pokeballs look like, but I do have an idea because I have Googled it a little bit. So, what they do have is kind of a white center with kind of a black ring around it, then coming out from it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, let's make it 7 across just like this. Okay, I'm not gonna be able to pick up those dirt blocks, but that's fine. I'll have to empty it anyway. I'll have to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 this way. Actually, you know, we can go 8 is fine. Can we go 8 the other way? That's the real question. If we can't go 8 this way, and yeah, I think we'll be able to, so we'll go 8. Then what we gotta do is we gotta make a circle. Okay, everybody, so I did figure out the little pattern that we need to make. Now, so what I did is I just added, like, from here on 2, 1, 2, 3, and then it's kind of straight. And I think that looks like a pretty circular Pokeball. If I need to fix it, I will, but yeah, now we just gotta kind of empty this out completely. Okay, guys, so it's completely filled in, but like I said, I think it does need a black rim around it, but that's actually not even a problem, because I can actually expand it by one more on every side. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to follow around the edge, and I'm going to put some more black wool. All right, everybody. So, yeah, it's a Pokeball now, which is nice. So that is kind of the ground. Now, what I do want to see, I do want to see it. All right, so let's take a look. It looks a little bit... All right, everybody. So I managed to move the entire Pokeball to over just because I needed a little bit of point room here. Now that I think about it, I should probably only moved it one over because now I don't have room on this side. Okay, guys, I've moved it again. This time one block over this way. This is like the fifth time I've done this, guys, but I gotta make it just right. So what we gotta do, though, is I wanna make this just a little bit more circular. So this is like about the middle. So we're gonna take about three blocks and move it over, and that'll make it a bit more circular. Let's do it the same on this side. About three blocks, one, two, three, add white. And that should make it more circular if we go back up. And that should look a bit better. Still looks better. All right, let's go up and see. See if it looks any different or any better from the original version. That looks about the same. In the end, all I really needed was a Pokeball, though. Yeah, can we... Now, that'll make it... I do still want it circular, though. I don't want it pointy, because then it'll just be, like, triangular. Alright, guys, so now what we're going to do is we're going to actually do the whole trainer with the Iron Golems part. Let me just fill this in with dirt, though. Right now, it's going to look ugly, but trust me, it'll grass over, probably even by the time we get done. So let's just fill this in. We'll let it grass over. I've lost a lot of the wool underneath, but oh well. I don't really care. Honestly, I have plenty of sheep. I even dyed them the colors so we could get this. It'll be really fine. Am I running out of dirt? No, I'm not. So yeah, if I ever can maybe make the Pokeball better, I will. But for now, I'm just going to leave it as is because I don't feel like doing hours and hours of work on it. I've already done enough. So if I can make it better, guys, in the future, I will. It'll only be like small changes, like making it more circular or something. But yeah, right now what we got to do is I was planning to put maybe the white or the birch fences on like the white part and then the dark oak on the red part. But since I have a black outline of it, I'm just going to use dark oak all the way around. Now, I think I might need to maybe, I don't know if I should add a second black layer. Alright, guys, so I have added kind of a second edge, and I've connected all the fences. So let's go up there probably for the final time and see it. Yeah, guys, I'm actually, this could be a little fixed up, but I'm okay with this. And let's just try one more thing. In some of the pictures, I did see that it even had a little black center. So let's just go see. We might remove that black center. For now, we'll leave it in though, because some Pokeball pictures do show them like that. But that'll be fine. That's enough work on it. Now let's actually put the Iron Golems in there. That's like the fun part because we'll be able to watch them. Thing is, I did forget my pumpkins. I don't have any pumpkins. Okay, well, actually, I do have pumpkins. And this is a good time for us to check up on the pumpkin and melon farms because we do never check on those. I check them like off camera, but never on camera. So let's go over there real quick and we can go ahead. Because I know you guys haven't seen them. So this is the melon farm. No, this is the pumpkin farm. Well, that you guys just saw the pumpkins. Let's go to the melon farm, see how this one's doing. So the melon farm is actually overflowing, and it's probably all getting stuck right there, but I'll have to fix that after the episode. I won't do it now. But yeah, we have plenty of pumpkins in here. All we need is two. Guys, we might need to make some chests for those, because the melons already filled up a while ago, and the pumpkins are getting pretty close to there, so we do need to be careful. But now, guys, what we're going to do, we're going to add Iron Golems in here, and they're going to be like two trainers, Gary and Ash. So I'm pretty sure I know how to make these. I haven't built one in so long. I'm pretty sure you build them like this, and then you take your pumpkins and you put one on top like that, and you make an Iron Golem. And we're going to do the same for this side. This is a lot of iron, but it's okay. Bam, that is an Iron Golem. And now we have two name tags, one for Gary, one for Ash. So we'll put Ashes on the white side. There's Ash, and we'll put Gary on this side. So now we have two trainers. We have Gary, and we have Ash, and they're both in here. They're Pokemon battling. I probably should add, like, two animals in here for, like, actual Pokemon. But what else I need to do is I do need to add some light, because torches are very important. Where are my torches? I know I used a lot of them. Do I have any left? I do. All right, perfect. Let's light the place up a bit, you know? I don't feel like getting spawns. I'm so used to playing in peaceful, I never light anything up, but I do have to start remembering to do that. Let's place a torch maybe here. Torch. I do want symmetry here, so let's place one there. One there. One there. Obviously one in the middle. One about middle. Middle. About right there. And that should light up the entire thing. Cool. Now, I should put two Pokemon in here. Maybe I should put, like, sheep or something. Yeah. I'm gonna go get some leads. I'm gonna try to get some animals in here. Okay, guys. So, I have added two mobs in there. Or, I'm gonna call them Pokemon because they're about to become Pokemon. Obviously, one was a sheep and the other one was a cow. Now, this is perfect because I was thinking, what Pokemon could they possibly be? Where's the cow? There's the cow. Blended in. What Pokemon could they possibly be? Well, in Pokemon, there is a sheep Pokemon. It's called Mareep. It is electric. So yeah, the sheep is going to be a sheep, Mareep. And the cow was a little bit harder to think of. I was thinking, what could be something brown and it's kind of an animal? Well, I thought, hold on. There's actually a cow Pokemon. It's called Miltank. The cow is going to be a cow. It's going to be Miltank. So yeah, we've got Ash and Gary. One's got a Miltank, the other one's got a Mareep. I don't know if Gary... Actually, I'm sure Gary never had... I'm going to say Gary had a Miltank. I know in the series he never had a Miltank, but I'm just going to say he does. And I'm pretty sure Ash had a Mareep in the later seasons, but I have no idea. Don't quote me on that because I have no idea. But guys, yeah, I think that's going to be it for today. We started the castle, we lit everything up, we built the Pokemon Arena. I say we did a bunch of stuff today. Well, guys, I had a lot of fun doing all the things, building, exploring, not really exploring, but whatever. I had a lot of fun today. Hopefully, you guys had a lot of fun watching. If you did, make sure to like and comment, as it supports my channel, and I'll see you guys later. God bless, and goodbye.